ะฮะใครใช้กลิ่นมาก่อนบ้างไหมครับโอเค Managing it should be okay for everybody okay please welcome Sam or Samuel about the gift
so hello everyone I hope that you guys didn't sleep or it is noon so let me introduce myself my name is Sam I'm from Indonesia Ubud Bali I come here specifically to talk about how gift fashion control changed my life so the introduction will be like people you know like you usually like uploading with FTP, FileZilla, and you just directly drop down your files to the, and directly edit your file manager, but it's a cowboy coding, like it's destructive, like, make your coding not work very well, and you have to check out files and you have to check out one by one, but if you are uploading with FTP, FTP is only you use like something like FileZilla. You directly just copying the files and you have to check out the file inside. It's not really like the best first solution. So what is a gift fashion control? How is it like? It is developed by the Linus Torvald. He's the creator of Linux. It's a version control that allows you to track any changes in your system, in your computer. So Git is a decentralized system. So it's live in you know anywhere, like in your local system, in your web server, in your repository online. So super efficient tracking tool system that allow you to pulling like the code like from your friend, for example, like you're working with your other friends, other developers that you work on a certain project, and you can pull like what your friend did, or you can also like merge what is like the current branch project, so it's easily become a better version. And so how it works is like it's tracking every update you make. So it has a history of every update. For example, like I'm making a commit, I add like a file, I update like okay, a paragraph below that I'm from Indonesia. And then tomorrow I change it, like okay, I'm from Bali, for example. And you get a track of this. And you can load like past updates and do comparison of coding. So you can compare like, oh, I have error now, and then what can error like, what did I change it? And you can check the lines and they do the comparison for you. And the most important thing is adding notes to every updates. You know, you want to let other people know what is the update that do like for example, I do this update for updating the function, a certain kind of function, and it's working right now. And then tomorrow, your friend's like, no, this function doesn't work, and I want to change it. And simply like that, it's a tracking tools that allow you to put a version. So before you connect it to WordPress, there's a certain rules that you have to know. Like because WordPress itself is made from many different files. It has the core, it has the upload, it has a sitemap, it has content, the theme, and the plugin, and the asset. You probably won't upload them all. Like for the example like wp-config, every environment that you have is different for every client. So you have to also accept that, put it in like, to ignore it, you have to put limitation inside the git. So you know that exactly what you're going to upload and what you're going to show to the other developers, so you can just easily edit that with and have a good product for your customers. So there's many ways how can you connect WordPress with Git. There's many ways that you can connect with Git. Like we have like GitHub, a desktop, we have WordPress version, we have like a lot of different tools for this. But specifically for this session, I'm going to tell you about a GitHub updater. So this GitHub updater is developed by Andy Fragten. He's like from Germany, and he's making this for uploading only the themes and plugins, so you easily like updating your plugin, your theme without including the you ignore like some different files, but you still need to ignore put limitation. For example, like you have to put limitation for .git or any other extension files that you don't want to put. So let's practice from installation. So here I show you that I put a plugin called Sam plugin. It's a test plugin and it's nothing. Well, inside you have like a different version and you have a function to put here to show in the WPI. So to manage this, to use this plugin, you need to integrate that in your admin. And there's a plugin called GitHub Updater, and you can like easily like activate this like installing a normal installation, and just activate that, and simply like. Plugin, you can install themes, even from like a private repository. If you have an access token, or you have a passport, or like GitLab or Gitbucket, this plugin is perfect for you. And so, for these certain things, first of all, what you need is SSH key. Because you need to connect your GitHub account to your local machine, so you need to deploy a key. And I'm already do that. So and then you need to update the hook. You need to append the hook for the remote management here. Because you have this kind of remote management. Can you copy that? Thank you. it's very fast. Like, you know, if the plugin just get just installed, like, completely, you know, without like any, you have to waiting for the plugin to get installed. Like, it's not like that. You just put it and the plugin install directly. And we go to the plugin page and boom, because my plugin is already active and I got the it's very small. I got the my plugin active for now. But I got an amazing magic trick for this. So for example, so I put the sharing them your repository let them like do full operator refresh, and they can easily like, change the code also inside the repository, and it's working with it. Any ideas that you have, and it's efficient, like you can just push it, or you want to connect it directly to your clients, and you just push it, you know, like, and that's it, it's automatically push it every time. So, thank you for...
Like
so in order to connect it,
have to have WP Migrate DB Pro. So it's easily like you can integrate your data.
This is focused only on file.
Yeah.